Hey everyone, Jason Case here with another video, and today I'm going to be a little technical with you, and we're going to discuss how using a 301 redirect wildcard can save you a ton of time. So if you're only updating a few URLs and adding a couple, 301 redirects, then this really isn't important. But if you're changing entire site structures around and all of your URLs are changing, which I wouldn't recommend necessarily, because that's a lot of changes and it could impact your rankings a lot. But if you have to, and if it's necessary, then I would suggest using 301 redirect wildcards. So before I get into that, if you're not familiar with what a 301 redirect is, this is letting the search engines know the new path of a URL. So if you've changed the URL of a page, then what will happen if you don't put this 301 redirect in, it will throw a 404 error page. And that's not good. You don't want to do this, because if you have external links pointing to this page, then it's providing a bad user experience. And also, when the search engines index and crawl this page, it sees it's not available either. So for multiple reasons, this isn't good. And what you want to do is redirect people that link to this page to the correct new page. So that's what a 301 redirect does. And a 301 redirect is a permanent redirect. Now, if you were only making a temporary change to the URL, then that would be a 302 redirect. But when you're updating a lot of different URLs, so let's just say, for example, it's your domain.com/category, so whatever this category is, and then / whatever your page name is. And inside that category, you have a bunch of different pages, right? Well, what you can do with a wildcard redirect, and let's just say inside that category, you have like 30 different pages. Instead of doing 30 different redirects, what you could do is do a wildcard redirect of every page within that category and then redirect it to the new category name. So this will save you a ton of time of adding a bunch of different redirects. Another reason this could be important is you might put a 301 redirect on a specific page, and then you start getting 404 errors for that page, but it was not that exact URL. So a lot of times, if a post gets shared on social media or some of these other platforms, it appends a question mark, share, blah, 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 to it. Well, if somebody accesses that page through that URL, then it'll throw a 404 page, because it's not that specific URL. So this is another scenario where a 301 redirect, like a wildcard, would come in place. So I'm not going to get into the details of how to set this up, because this is different on every different platform. It depends on what CMS system or how your website's set up. So just talk to your web developer about this, or you can reach out to us. This is what we do. And we have a team of web developers here that can help you with this as well. But a lot of times when this comes into play is if you're reorganizing the structure of your URL during a website redesign, or if like a lot of your blog posts are using kind of unfriendly search engine URLs that has a bunch of numbers and characters in it, and you want to make it a more friendly search engine URL, then you might have to redirect a lot of URLs, and then in this case a wildcard 301 redirect could help you. So either way, this conversation came up today, or not today, a couple days ago here at our work, and I thought it would be a great topic for today's video, just to go over this, because it could save you a ton of time instead of adding hundreds of 301 redirects to your website. Either way, take care everyone, and we'll talk tomorrow.